Hello guys, welcome back to another video. As some of you may know, I have been gone for the last 4 months, so I wanted to make a video to give you guys an update. Now, if you're already in my survival game Discord server, the chances are you already saw my announcement that I made. But basically, around October last year is when I uploaded my last video. And around the end of October, I got very sick to the point where I was stuck in bed for a couple of days, and I had a really bad fever, feeling super weak. And I was coughing up this sort of mucus, and I waited a couple of days. My condition never got any better. So eventually I went into the emergency room where they told me I had pneumonia. Now, pneumonia is sort of this infection in either one or both of your lungs where it causes the air sacs to fill up with fluid. And so I was coughing up all of this mucus, and it was very bad. I was coughing to the point where basically I needed to puke. And this story actually dates back even further than this. I've always had this cough. So if we go back all the way back to 2022, early 2022, I got sick. And after recovering from being sick, I sort of had this lingering cough. And for those of you who don't know, I actually lived up in Alaska at this time. And so I went up to the doctors there. I saw the doctors and I tried to get rid of this cough that I had, but it could never go away. We did all sorts of things like taking antibiotics, all sorts of different tests to try and get rid of the cough that I had. But late towards the end of 2022, around October is when I started creating my survival game course. And I was super busy around this time because I was getting all the content out for that on top of working a 9-to-5 job. So I actually had a full-time job at the same time. And basically I was putting all my spare time into designing the course, developing it, recording the lectures, editing them. I really didn't have any time to focus on my health or figure out why I still have this cough. But eventually things got pretty worse. And in early 2023, I actually went up to the hospital up in Alaska because I gotten like an ear infection. If you never had an ear infection, it can range from being mild pain to very extreme pain. And unfortunately, it got to the point where it was probably like the worst pain that I've ever experienced. And I think it's best described as someone driving something into your ear. It's a very sharp pain. Now, I'm not the type of guy to go to doctors immediately to try and be seen to fix things up, mainly because back in Alaska, they really didn't have like the resources. And it almost felt like whenever I'd go to the doctor, they would just tell me to take ibuprofen and tell me, doesn't get better, come back in a couple weeks and we'll see you again. It basically just seemed like they were trying to rush me out of the door. So I never really liked that about going to the doctors up there. I was always very hesitant to try and receive any sort of treatment, any sort of medication because of that. Not to mention, your insurance, even if you have insurance, it wouldn't really cover the cost of the visit. So you end up wasting your time, end up wasting your money for them to just tell you to, go take ibuprofen and come back in 2 weeks if it's not any better. So essentially, because of that, I'd wait till, the condition that I was in was to the worst point that it possibly could be. And long story short, I couldn't wait any longer because of this ear infection that I had. I went to the doctor. They gave me medication. This is early 2023. Took the medication. It made me feel better. But then I had a side effect because of it. I got C. diff, which is sort of like a side effect of taking antibiotics. Basically, you can sort of think of it as having like a stomach ache, but like 10 times worse. You're basically using the bathroom every 30 minutes. You can't eat or drink any food because you just puke it up. And so I think I'd gone like 24 hours without eating or drinking any food before I went into the emergency room to try and figure out what I had. And so they found out I had C. diff. They gave me medication for that. And so I took that. And then a couple weeks later, I got my ear infection again. And so this time I didn't want to go back to the doctors because I didn't want to get C. diff. I didn't want to take the medication. So I was very scared. And again, I'd waited for the situation to get to the worst that it possibly could before I was basically trying to figure out, which is worse. Is the pain from having an ear infection or is the pain from having C. diff any better? I actually went back in. I told them everything and they gave me a different medication that helped with the ear infection. But this was all of 2023, the beginning of the year. So the past like 3 months of the beginning of the year, I just felt like I got screwed over by life. Like just constant ear infection after ear infection and side effect from the medication. And at this time, I was still working the full-time job on top of trying to upload videos and lectures for the course. And it was a lot of work. Probably one of the hardest times of my life. Like I remember being in complete pain in my room, waking up at 3 a.m., not being able to sleep, pacing through my room because of like the ear infection, the pain in my ear. And around this time too, I still had the persistent cough. Like I was coughing up lots of mucus. I tried seeing doctors, trying to figure out why I had this cough. Even though I felt better, I wasn't sick or anything like that. And we did all sorts of tests up there. We did things like x-ray, a CT scan, all sorts of lung function testing, see if I had like asthma. And they gave me all sorts of medication to fix it, but it just felt like the medication they gave me was to suppress the cough, and it never really tried to figure out the root cause of it. And another part of that was they didn't really have the resources, the doctors, the specialists up there in Alaska that could actually treat me or figure out what I had. So eventually we did like a couple months of different tests, me going back and forth to the doctor, you know, seeing them multiple times a week. And they eventually came to the conclusion that I needed to see like a pulmonologist or a lung specialist to try and figure out why I had this persistent cough in my lungs. Now, unfortunately, there aren't any like pulmonologists up in Alaska, or at least close to where I lived. So like the closest one would be, I'd have to fly down to Seattle, Washington, and we didn't know if my insurance would cover it, all of that stuff. And so I already, you know, knew that this would be really expensive if I were to try and figure out what I had. So I just had to brush it off, because around this time in 2023 is when I was also planning on moving down to Texas. So I just thought maybe I can wait till I move, and then I can actually go and see a specialist down there that will be able to treat and find out what I have. So fast forward to May 2023, I moved all the way down from Alaska to Texas. It was a very long journey. It was about like a 4-day ferry ride. So I took the ferry down and stopped in Washington. I drove all the way through all the different states, all the way down to Texas. And that was about 3 days straight of driving. But long story short, I moved down to Texas. I actually started to feel a lot better. Like the environment was a lot more of a warmer climate, obviously. And so I felt like my cough had improved and wasn't as severe as it was back up in Alaska. So I kind of just brushed off, going to see a specialist, going to the doctor and all that stuff. So this brings our story back to October of 2023 when I stopped uploading videos. Around this time, like I mentioned, I got very sick. I was stuck in bed for a week. I had another ear infection and the fever was really bad. I wasn't eating any food. And eventually the pain in my ear was so severe that I just went into the emergency room. I just had to be seen. And the cough that I had was also very bad. It progressed to the point where I couldn't stop coughing, to the point of like vomiting. And they essentially told me that I had pneumonia. And so they gave me the antibiotics I needed to get rid of the pneumonia, and it helped my ear infection and the cough that I had. And so they wanted to set up an appointment with a doctor. And so I had set up an appointment, and I think the closest that they could get me, unfortunately, was December 26th. So like the day after Christmas was the only appointment that they had available. So I took that, and unfortunately they at the last minute rescheduled my appointment. And so I missed it, and I had to schedule it a month later. This is January 26, 2024. So after time passed, I finally was able to meet with a doctor. And this is just a normal psychiatrist. So before I can actually see a pulmonologist, I had to make contact with like a primary care provider. And so I explained, you know, everything to him, the cough that I've had, basically all the different tests that I did up in Alaska and how they concluded I need to see like a pulmonologist. So he got the referral sent in. And about a week later, I went and saw a pulmonologist finally. So this is about like early February. I went in and I talked to a pulmonologist. I explained everything to them. We did tons of different testing over the next couple of weeks, things like blood testing, x-ray, CT scan. They sampled stuff from my cough, and basically they were trying to figure out, you know, what was causing the cough. What was the root cause of it? Is it because there's a bacterial infection or a fungal infection? Basically, they wanted to find the root cause, which, I mean, I've got to give it to the pulmonology department. They have a full department there with an amazing team of talented people. And I mean, up in Alaska, they didn't have any of these resources. They didn't even have like one specialist up there that could look at this. And mind you, I should probably mention, I'm not like a smoker. This is not due to anything in particular. I've lived a pretty healthy, normal life. So they did all sorts of tests. And the main thing they wanted to find out was the reason behind my cough and why it never went away despite using many different types of antibiotics. And long story short, they basically found that I had some sort of bacterial infection in my lungs that was resistant to the normal type of antibiotics that you would use, like penicillin, amoxicillin. And basically this infection was responsible for all of the ear infections that I had, reoccurring sickness and all that stuff. So just to make sure, they wanted to do a bronchoscopy, which is basically a procedure where they take a camera and they stick it down your throat into your lungs, and they can look around and see inside of your lungs. And also they can sample some of the stuff inside of your lungs. They just wanted to check and see if there's any abnormalities, any things like cancer and stuff like that, and also sample some of the stuff inside of my lung. So this procedure wasn't that fun. You know, they put you to sleep and basically they put this camera down your throat, and there's a lot of side effects afterwards. Like you have a really bad sore throat, you're coughing up blood, all that stuff. Fast forward to about, 2 weeks ago, they called me up. They told me all the results of the procedure, and luckily they didn't find anything like any abnormalities, like cancer or anything. I don't have any of that, but they did find that I had that bacterial infection in my lungs responsible for all of the ear infections that I was getting. And so they prescribed me a different type of antibiotic that would target this particular infection. And so I've been taking that for the past like 10 days. I actually just finished it. But the cough, it has improved a little bit. You know, it still isn't gone 100%. So we're still obviously working on that. Another thing that they did was actually tested my blood to see if I was like immune and compromised. And they basically found out that I had less than the measurable amount of antibodies. Basically, they couldn't measure it because I don't have enough in my blood system. These antibodies are responsible for things like fighting off bacteria and illnesses. It's basically your immune system ability to fight off stuff like the common cold when you get sick. And unfortunately for me, they diagnosed me with CVID, or common variable immune deficiency, which is the reason why I have many reoccurring infections in my body, and it can't fight off the cold or sickness by itself. I always have to use some sort of antibiotics to get better. Now, they did tell me the immune deficiency is treatable, meaning they can give me the antibodies that I need to fight off illnesses, but this is like a lifelong journey, something that I'd have to get reoccurring treatments for. And obviously, I'm still going to get very sick often because of this. And I think the most important thing is to keep going no matter what. I mean, throughout the past couple of years of being sick and working through it, I never really took a long enough break to focus on my health. Basically, that's where I've been this entire time and why I haven't been uploading any videos. I mean, I feel like life has just kicked me in the ass these couple of months. And recently, I feel like I'm just sitting down, taking a beating. I'm not doing anything about it, even though I'm getting the treatment that I need, going to the hospital, seeing the doctors. And I just feel like I want to fight back. I want to start uploading videos again. I want to start doing what I love, even though I feel like crap every day. I might not feel the best. I just can't sit around anymore and do nothing about it and wait till I get better, because I've been doing that the past couple months and I don't feel good about it. So you should have saw me back in October 2022. I mean, I remember when I was very sick, laying in bed. I had my laptop open with one earbud in and I was editing up a video, listening back to it, making sure that the audio was all good. And I didn't care. I just worked every single day, editing videos, uploading, recording, even though I felt sick, even though I was tired. And I want to get back into doing that because I feel like that's the only way I can bounce back from this and stop getting my ass beat by life. So yeah, I'm planning on making a full return to the channel, uploading more content. I'm also still working on my survival game course. So for those of you who are in the Discord, I already made an announcement on my plans for the course. Basically, the course is complete in terms of all 21 chapters of content is there. However, there are a few additional lectures and content that I'm planning on adding. And the other announcement is I want to actually remaster the course because it is a year old. So there's a lot of changes within the different versions of the engine, but also there's a lot of improvements that I'd like to make to these systems in the course. And there's a lot of features of the engine that I'd like to utilize in the remaster. So for example, a lot of people are mentioning things like adding third person and first person camera support. So I feel like this is something that I should include in the remaster, as well as a lot of other additions, things like controller support and much more. Now, that being said, this remaster is going to be free for everyone who has purchase the course already. So I'm not going to charge you guys for the same course, basically. And a lot of you might already know that because you read the announcement in the Discord server. But likewise, there is going to be a lot of work ahead of me. I mean, I feel like I can make a lot of improvements to the way that the game is designed and utilize a lot of the new features, things like common UI, enhanced input, and adding controller support, and using things like data assets for better memory management. So I think this can be very beneficial in the long run because I think these are very important things that everyone should learn. And I feel like it will help me a lot improve on designing games in the future. Anyways, I'm going to start uploading again. I'm going to start working on the survival game course remaster. I'm going to keep you guys updated on the progress of that. And in terms of Unreal Engine news, we're actually getting a new version of the engine, Unreal Engine 5.4. So up here in March, during GDC, I think we're going to get a preview of the engine. So there's going to be a lot of news around that, a lot of new features. And hopefully this is the version that I plan to remaster the course in, to record all the lectures and all that stuff and update it too. So yeah, there's a lot of videos that I want to make. And we actually recently hit 100K subscribers last year. So I want to make a video about that as well. And I just want to keep making Unreal Engine content because that is what I love to do. So anyways, if you guys stuck around to the end of the video, I appreciate you so much. And we're back. And like always, I'll see you guys in the next video.